Hello everyone, James with you. I hope everybody's having a nice day. We're getting back started with more LA Noir. Before we get started in the game, I just want to give you a little background on myself in reverence or relation to this game. Once upon a time, I used to work for the medical examiner's office in Florida with a company called Professional. What this company would do is would go out and they would do removals for the medical examiner's office. See, down in Florida, ambulances don't remove the deceased. We do. What we would do, we go out and just strictly pick the remains up and take it into the medical examiner's office. We had no police authority or anything like that to do any investigations. We were just a removal service. We dealt with homicides, suicides, traffic fatalities, decomposed cases that had been, you know, a couple of months in the woods or something like that. So when it comes to LA Noir, go to a crime scene, I mean, I've seen it all, go to this stuff before. It's not no big surprise to me. So, you know, that's my background with the medical examiner's office. I've done quite a few removals, and working for the service that supplied the removal services for the medical examiner's office Professional, I was a statewide removal specialist. Now, my company had six different counties. We had something like Melbourne, we had Fort Lauderdale, Palm Beach, Miami, we had Pinellas, St. Pete, and Tampa. And then if we were called to some other place in the state, that's, you know, I was the only one qualified to go get those bodies anywhere in the state. Well, let me rephrase that. I was the only one stupid enough to go. But that's my background with the medical examiner's office in any police situation. Of course, being trained also in law enforcement, that would give me a little bit more upright. But like I say, when you play this game, you'll be open-minded and listen to what's being said and make sure you examine all the clues. Okay, we're gonna get on with the game now. I think I've done enough talking. We'll be right back. Oh, we're playing clothes now.
Here's your new desk, kid. You're on traffic. The hot sheet is posted here, next to the map.
What's his problem?
That's Biggs. He's an institution.
So this is what all the fuss is about. Why couldn't they build a freeway that goes past my place?
They haven't even approved the money yet, kid. The bond issue won't be till December. It'll be years before any of this will happen. Here's your new partner, Stefan Berkowski.
I've heard all about you, Phelps. You go easy on me and let me earn the odd citation, and maybe we'll get along fine. I'm here to learn, Detective.
He's an intense one, isn't he, Mel?
Who's intense?
The newly minted detective here, Cole Phelps.
Hi, Phelps. I'll be keeping an eye on you. I could spend a little time basking in reflected glory, make a change from busting hookers and dope fiends.
Who was that, Commander?
Roy Earle, Chief Detective and Advice.
Do they all dress like movie stars?
Well, Roy is a movie star. And the whole of the seedy side of L.A. is his audience.
What is that supposed to mean?
Stick with me, kid. You'll find out.
And now some housekeeping. Warm Central Division welcome for Detective Cole Phelps. Some of you guys may know Phelps. He's the cop who broke the jewelry store murder. Stand up and take a bow, Phelps.
If it's all right with you,
that's
sir.
That's an order, Phelps.
Quiet, buddy.
Phelps is one of only two serving LAPD officers who received the Silver Star during the war. Really gave it those lousy Japanese, eh, Phelps?
I did my best, Captain.
Why, you war hero is always so modest. I partnered Phelps with everybody's favorite Pole, Stefan Bukowski.
Hope you like work, kid. Bukowski sure as hell doesn't.
Well, that's why we are partners, right?
Okay, can it, guys. Stick with Bukowski. He's a good cop. He knows traffic inside and out. I'm going to start you out with one case. You do okay, I'll give you a couple more. You screw up, you'll be rousing vagrants and running license plates. Now get down to the P.E. Freight Depot, 6th and Alameda. A patrolman called in a suspicious vehicle. Signs of foul play. See what you can find out.
Come on, Phelps.
I think I'd better be a beat cop than a detective. Get out of there.
They really pushed you through quick, didn't they? 6 years on patrol before I got this desk. You were here in 5 minutes.
What do you want me to say? I didn't ask for any favors.
Welcome back to L.A. Noir, everyone.
Olive oil comes from olives.
This canary says he'll sing, but only if I guarantee he walks.
Okay. Where are you going? This is our patrol car?
You know this place?
Sure.
Near the old gasworks and signal depot in the warehouse district.
Whoa!
I'll direct.
The same goes for quality beer.
All units of 459 just occurred in 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2, identified.
So, tell me a little about yourself, Phelps. Are we friends now, Bukowski? We have to work together, don't be so touchy. Grew up in San Francisco. My father was in shipping. Went to college at Stanford. Did 2 years ROTC before Marine OCS at Camp Elliott. Shipped out in early 45 as a first lieutenant and fought in the Okinawa campaign. Wounded, shipped back home. Did a year on the beat. Now I'm here. So you won the Silver Star. I don't want to talk about it. Now let me get this straight. You single-handedly killed 40 Japs on this hill in Okinawa. No. You were up there all night, draped in the flag, knife between your teeth, gun at the ready. Finished? The Emperor Hirohito himself leading the charge against you.
I did my part, Bukowski.
What did you do? I kept the streets of L.A. safe for the people.
Yeah. Now I get it. Unfit for service.
Fuck you, Phelps. I earned a bravery citation during the Zeta riots.
Sounds like you had it rough. I did my job. No one is saying you didn't.
I did 6 years at Timbuktu.
That's the...
All units of 459 just occurred at 6th and Saris. Any unit to handle, code 2, identified.
She told me not to play around, but I done let the deal go down, so pack it on over.
Listen to this music.
That you, Bukowski? Go on through. Parking lot straight ahead.
Okay, let's get this investigation going. Kick it up into high gear.
I need to get back to work, officer.
The detectives are here now. You repeat to them what you told me.
I did the right thing by calling this in. I'm just a working stiff.
Just give them your story and you'll be all right.
Awful nervous for a witness.
This is your first case, Phelps. It's okay to admit it if you're stumped. If you don't know what to do next, just come talk to me and we'll see what we can figure out.
Thanks, Stefan. You're okay.
I'm Officer Hart.
Phelps, traffic. What have you got?
Abandoned car, probably stolen. The solid citizen is Nate Wilkie. He called it in.
What gives with the coroner?
There's blood all over the interior. Someone's copped the full Broderick, but no stiff as yet.
We have an owner for the car?
The car is registered to an Adrian Black, just north of Bunker Hill.
All right.
Bunker Hill, huh?
I'll keep Mr. Wilkie talking, but don't make him wait too long.
Well, that Bunker Hill was in Boston. Type.
Nice day for it.
Now, first things first.
How long you gonna keep me here, sir?
As long as it takes.
I better get back to work, sir.
And I guess that's the wife. Stenzel.
Stenzel glasses. Home repaired by the look of it.
Well, most of them are. Let's see what else we got. Don't want to miss anything. Come back here.
The brand name might give us something to go on.
Guys, take your time. No freight rolling through here till we're done. And we're still punching the clock.
Victim, that's way too much blood for a
lot of blood.
A human corpse. Way too much. Or just one body anyway.
This isn't what we're looking for.
No, but it's nice to know it's there. What we got here? Riverside Slaughterhouse.
Morgan picked up a live pig yesterday.
$3.20 for a live. That's not bad. Oh, I miss the old days. I'd like to have today's money with yesterday's prices. Are you going to let me talk to the witness? Oh.
Sir, I'm Detective Phelps.
Name's Nate Wilkie.
You found the vehicle?
Sure. Saw it just sitting there. Strange place to be parking your car. Figured I'd better take a look. And then I saw all the blood. So I called the police.
Mind if I ask what you were doing out here?
Well, I work for the railway. I was on my way out to the switch and reckon I'd take a shortcut.
I believe him, so I'm gonna go with good cop.
Did you see anybody else in the yard? Maybe somebody hanging around the car?
Nope. I hadn't seen a soul all day till you boys turned up.
Do you know Adrian Black, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. That ain't a name I'm familiar with.
You ever seen the car before?
Funny enough, I did. A couple of nights ago, it was over there in the parking lot. I know most of the cars that park here regularly, so it kind of stood out.
We found a steel pipe with blood on it near the car. Do you know anything about it, Mr. Wilkie?
No, sir. I went straight for the law when I saw the car was full of blood.
That I believe.
When you saw the blood, was it wet, bright red, or darker like it is now?
Darker, I'd say. Looked dry already.
Thank you for your patience, Mr. Wilkie. If you don't mind waiting a little longer, I'm sure we'll have more questions once we've had a look around. Doc?
Detective
Phelps. What have we got?
A lot of blood for a blunt force injury. Victim must be in a very bad way.
Any sign of the guy?
Not unless he's in the trunk of the car.
No, he's not in the trunk of the car, that's for sure. We make sure around here we got everything. We don't want to miss any clues.
Hey, Flatfoot, you're looking to get rid of that old crate? I'll give you a nickel for it.
There's got to be something else here. Let me look at this wallet again.
Happier times, I guess.
Looks like the house behind it could use some paint job. Well, what was that?
Years old, married. Sounds like an average guy. What was he doing out here?
One more time here.
I'm at a loss.
Have a word with the witness. It's not often we get eyeballs in a case like this.
Get over here.
The wallet by the car. Was there anything in it when you arrived?
You accusing me of something, mister?
Yeah, now I am accusing you.
Tell the truth, Mr. Wilkie. You rifled the wallet.
My money is my money. You can't prove I touched that wallet. Man does the right thing, and the police try to turn him into a criminal.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Wilkie. We'll contact your employer if we need anything more from you.
If you have to, I guess. I can't really spend no more time over this.
Somebody's got to inform the wife, Phelps. If you're done here, we'll head over there now.
I guess we're as done as we're ever going to be.